Hi, welcome back to understand the program, which is to count the number of zeros and ones stored in two consecutive memory locations. For this program, we are taking the numbers 7 and 3, and for these two numbers, we find how many zeros and ones are there, which is of 32-bit representation. These two numbers are stored in a label location called as value of the type DCD. The number 7 in 32 bits has 3 ones and 29 zeros. The number 3 in 32-bit representation will have 2 ones and 30 zeros. This totals to 5 ones and 59 zeros. So on execution of the program, we need to display the answer as the number of zeros and ones for the two numbers 7 and 3 as 5 ones and 59 zeros. A 59 in the hexadecimal representation is going to be 3B. Let us understand the program from the code segment. We have an assembler directive called as an area. The name given to the program is 1 and 0's. Start with the code segment, which is of read only. The first instruction, move R2, 0, represents that R2 is a register which is a counter for counting the number of ones, R3 a register to count the number of zeros. Since there are two numbers for which we find ones and zero, R7 is initialized to 2. The next instruction indicates that R6 is a pointer pointing to a memory location labeled as value. Since there are 32 bit numbers we are considering, R1 is initialized to 32. With execution of this, the contents of R6 will be moved to the register R0, and then R6 will point to the next memory location, which is of the number 03. So on the first time, the number 7 will be moved to the register R0. We have already discussed what is move S with ROR, a barrel shift instruction. By doing an ROR, it is rotate right by 1 bit, and because we have S being suffixed with the move instruction, the carry flag is updated. On doing a rotate right instruction, the carry flag is checked whether it is ones or zeros. Now when I take the first number 7, the LSB bit is 1, so on rotation 1 goes to the carry flag. Since the carry flag is 1, it goes to a labeled location called as ones, and in the labeled location we have a register R2 which is incremented by 1, so R2 becomes 1. Since we have finished the execution of the first bit on the number 7, we subtract it by 1, where R1 is a counter to count the number of 32 bits. So R1 is subtracted. Again, it goes back to loop 0. This part of the loop gets executed 32 times since each number is of 32 bits. On every rotation, it is going to check the carry flag. And if my carry flag on a rotation contains 0, then it goes to this labeled location and R3 is being incremented. After incrementing R3, it branches directly to the label location called as loop 1, and then R1 is being decremented. So in this way, it finds how many zeros and ones are there by getting onto the loop for 32 times for the first number. On completion of the 32 bit, it is going to do the next operation, SUBS R7. That means R7 is decremented by 1 since we have finished with first number. And we have another number to make the comparison or to count the number of zeros and ones. So it checks that there is a second number. So it goes back to the loop doing the operation for the second number. On completion of the first and the second number counting the zeros and ones, it comes to the next instruction, which is the branch instruction for stopping the program. So on execution of this, it is going to show R2 contains the number of ones, which is 5, and R3 a counter which counts the number of zeros in the two numbers 7 and 3. So it will be 5B, and then we see the execution. Let us execute this program by clicking on the evaluation mode as OK, and we run the program. And on stopping this, you see that the register R2 has the value as 5, which counts the number of 1's in this number 7 and 3. Similarly, R3 will show the value as 3B, and 3B is a hexadecimal number for the total number of zeros, which are going to be 59. This way we have learned how to execute the program 8, which is counting of zeros and 1's of the two numbers stored in the location labeled as value and of the type DCD. Thank you for watching this video. If you have learned from this video, do support the channel by clicking on subscribe and pressing the like button.